Hello everyone, today I want to share with you how to make boho style shoulder bag. This is granny squares. This is classic granny square. These two squares, they are a little bit fancier. If you haven't seen my tutorial how to make this granny squares, it will be a link in the description below. In this tutorial I will not repeat it. You can use any squares for this bag basically. You can make just three ordinary granny squares, three classic granny square, or you can make three fancy granny square. It could be different type of squares. I was using for that drops number 9. This is recycled cotton and it is 50 gram, 125 meters. And I was using two strands at once because I wanted to make it solid, thick and heavy. So, and for each square I used two balls, so 100 gram, 200, 300. And for the straps, so around 350 you should count for this bag. And I was using hook 5 millimeters. This is it. I will show you quickly how to make a classic granny square, and then we will make flaps and get this bag together. It's very easy tutorial, suitable for beginners. This is quite large bag, and if you measure this across, it will be 43 centimeters or 17 inches. Obviously, if you want this bag to be smaller or larger, you will just adjust the size of your squares. Let's start with chain 4. Slip stitch to connect your circle. Chain 3. Two double crochets in the circle. This will be one side. Chain 2. Three double crochets in the circle. This is second side. Chain 2. Three double crochets in the circle. This is third side. Chain 2, 3 double crochet in the circle. Chain 2, slip stitch in the third chain. You've made a square. This is first row. Chain 3. There are lots of ways how to make it. I think the easiest way if we turn around. And this chain 3 will work as double crochet for this corner, because it is naturally, it's closer to this corner. So two double crochets in the same corner. Chain 2, 3 double crochets in the corner, chain One corner is done. Next corner, 3 double crochets. Chain 2, 3 double crochets. And this is corner number 2. I will make 2 more corners like that. Four corners have done, and now to finish the row, slip stitch in the third chain. Just like that. Row 3, chain 3, and now again I will turn my square like this. And this chain 3 will work as double crochet for this space. So I will make 2 more double crochets in this space. One side. Then for the corner, 3 double crochets, chain 2, 3 double crochets. You may find some patterns, a little bit variety with number of chains. Some patterns can ask for chain 1 between those triple crochets, those clusters. Yeah, and maybe to make chain 3 in the corner. In my pattern, I do chain 2 in the corner and I don't make any chains on the side. But you watch out for your yarn how you do. This is just a simple alteration that you can make. So this is the corner. For the side, in this space I will make 3 double crochets. Side. Now for the corner, 3 double crochets, chain 2, 3 double crochets, 1, 2, and 3, chain 2, and 3 double crochets. You have done second corner, it looks like a square. The side, 3 double crochets in this space. Now for the corner, 3 double crochet, chain 2, 3 double crochets. And this is classic granny square. This is how it looks. 3 corners have made. So I need to place 3 double crochet 3 double crochet, chain 2, 3 double crochet on the corner, and finish the row. And I will tell you in a second how to make this square larger, because this square can be made with a very big size. You just keep going. This is the last double crochet on this corner. Slip stitch in the third chain. And this is row 3. Chain 3. Turn it over. And start again with this space. Two more double crochets in this space, the corner will be exactly the same. 3 double crochet, chain 2, chain 2, 3 double crochets. If you crochet along with me, you can always click on the settings of this video and playback speed, make it 2 times slower. You've done corner. Now for the side, I have now 2 spaces, so it will be 2 times. I will make 3 double crochets here and 3 double crochets over there. And this will be the difference between the rows. So each row will have 1 more space on the side. And this is it. This is the pattern. This is the side, and for the corner, 3 double crochets, chain 2, 3 double crochets. So each row you will turn your work around, start with the space that you have your chain from, and each row you will have 1 more space more. So next row you will have 1, 2 and 3 space on side, then it will be 4, then it will be 5, and go on. So your square will grow larger and larger and larger. I will make my square large enough for my boho bag. I'm making a bag. And now when you've got all your 3 squares ready, we can fold the bag. Place them wrong side facing you. You see those tails there? Wrong side. And now let's fold it. First, the bottom bit, like this, then sides, you make triangles, and the last one, and this will be the back. To stitch the sides, you just stitch from this side and then all the way back. I will stitch it with single crochets like this, and then the other side, you go from this side corner and all the way up to the other side, and this will be the back. I will start with this side. It doesn't matter, I just like it this way. Insert your hook in a corner, pick the yarn, loop, and start making single crochet. I will try to pick 4 loops all at once. And I will just go along the edge. Just like that. Very simple and effective. To make little flap on your opening, I will make slip knot, chain 9, second chain stitch, single crochet, and I will make 8 single crochet, 1 in each chain stitch. Chain 1, turn the work, row 2, 8 single crochets, chain 1, turn the work, and I will keep going for 17 rows. And then we will make a little triangle. I will show you how to make a little triangle. To make little corner, chain 1. I will start not with the first stitch, I will start with second stitch. This will be 1 stitch decrease, making 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 single crochets. And the last 2 I will decrease, I will make 2 together. Like that. Chain 1. Decrease again. I will start not with the first stitch, I will start with the second stitch. 1, 2, 3. And last 2 stitches I will decrease. I will make 2 single crochet in one, chain one, and again next row don't start with the first stitch, start with the second. So it will be one stitch and last two stitches decrease. And this is it. Chain one and make one more last decrease. Just like that. Make chain one, cut the yarn. If you want, you can put the tassel. I've made the tassel separately and stitch this, attach this to this little flap. Then you attach the flap, and this is how it will look. It will go across your opening. For shoulder straps, I've done exactly the same. It is a chain 9 you start, and 8 single crochets all along, and I've made 44 rows. Finish it with chain 1. And cut the yarn. I cut one string off and I left one tail. I will use it to attach this to the back. Attaching to the back somewhere like this. Of course, you measure yourself how long you want this shoulder strip to be. You can pin this slightly. Use a sewing machine or stitch it by hands. Just want to make sure that it is corner to corner, kind of like this. And using this end, I will attach this corner. Just do your best. It's nothing right or wrong here. You're just attaching the shoulder strap, and do it on the other side as well. I will try to attach this securely. And then I will go around this triangle area. In and out the best you can. All you need to do is to weave from those ends. And this is how I do it. If your ends a little bit small, you do it like this. First insert the needle and then pick your ends. Just like that and pull it. And this will be great. You do it around the back and your back will be ready. This is how it looks.